I perceive and sense that there is a need for the people of our nation to be encouraged a little. Am I communicating? Just assisted. Like I said, Dr. Ms. Enenche went out on evangelism yesterday, and the climate was terrible. Depression, gloominess, disappointment, frustration, sorrow, like a mourning mood. She had to try to bring people out. Previously, this kind of place would have been jammed and crowded with people. But I have some scriptures and words for us in this season. Scripture number one is Proverbs 19:21. There are many devices in a man's heart. Nevertheless, the counsel of the Lord that shall stand. There are many devices in a man's heart. There can be many orchestrations, manipulations, whatever it is, in the hearts and minds of people. But the counsel of the Lord, that shall stand. Scripture number two. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. That is Nigeria. It is the expected end that shall be your outcome. To give you an expected end. If it is not the expected end, it is not over yet. If it is not the expected end, it is not over yet. Isaiah 65 verse 23. They shall not labor. Someone say, I shall not labor in vain. They shall not labor in vain, nor bring forth for trouble. For they are the seed of the blessed of the Lord, and their offspring with them. Look at your neighbor, say, you didn't waste your time. Say, we didn't waste our time. We didn't waste our effort. We did not labor in vain. We did not go out to vote in vain. We can never labor in vain. That is the God we serve. And that is what he told us in Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10 and chapter 6 verse 10a. He said, for God is not unrighteous. 6, 10a. For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love. We can stop there. In our love for our nation, in our love for the future God has for us, we did everything we could. He said, God is not unrighteous to forget. Look at your neighbor, say, God has not forgotten. The labor you have labored, we have labored for our nation, and God shall reward our labor. Say amen. Job chapter 20, verse 4 to verse 6. I'd like you to pay attention to this carefully. Say, knowest thou not this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short? And the joy of the hypocrite is for a moment. You can go to sleep on this world. That since old time, place it there. Ayagalagayaya. Knowest not thou this of old, since man was placed upon the earth, that the triumphing, except it's not wicked. If it is wicked, the triumphing of the wicked is short. The joy of the hypocrite, but for a moment. Look at verse 6. Though his excellency mount up to the heavens and his head reach unto the clouds. 7. Yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he?
it again. I want to read it again. God has every answer in scripture.
From verse 4.
Everybody read it together. One, two, go. Knowest thou not this of old? Since man was placed upon earth.
4-7.
That the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of a hypocrite is but for a moment. Though his excellency mount up to the heavens, and his head reach unto the clouds, yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? There are direct scriptures. So look at another one. Take your seat.
Ezekiel 21, 24 to 27. In the Living Bible first, 24 to 26 in the Living Bible, and 27 in King James Version.
The Lord says, again and again, your guilt cries out against you, for your sins are open and unashamed. Wherever you go, whatever you do, all is filled with sin. And now the time of punishment has come. He said it is open, unashamed. Does that remind you of anything? Open and unashamed. Again and again, your guilt cries against you, for your sins are open and unashamed. Wherever you go, whatever you do, it is all filled with sin. And now, the time of punishment has come. O King Zedekiah, evil prince of Israel, you can fill that with any name you want. Your final day of reckoning is here. Take off your crown. The Lord God says, the old order changes. Old order, old order, old order, old order. Old order, old order, old order, old order. The old order changes. Now the poor are exalted, and the rich brought very low. I will overturn, overturn, overturn it. King James Version. I will overturn, overturn, overturn it. And it shall be no more until he come whose right it is. And I will give it to him. Stand on your feet and shout. Ay, 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 ay. I will overturn. I will overturn. I will overturn it until it comes whose right it is. And I will give it to him. Say after me, say, Father, overturn.
Father, overturn.
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 Overturn it.
Overturn it.
And give it to him. Say, give it to him.
It to
whose
him.
Right it is. In the name of Jesus. Word number 7. This is the lion, Archbishop B.A. Idahosa. He said, in the race between lie and truth, lie may win at first, but truth will win at last. Read it again. In the race between lie and truth, lie may win at first, but truth will win at last. In the battle between good and evil, evil may prevail at first, but good must triumph at last. When the will of man clashes with the will of God, the will of man perishes and the will of God flourishes. Whatever is built on good grounds will come to good ends. But whatever is built on nothing will come to nothing. Whatever is built on truth will triumph. But whatever is built on falsehood must fail. No one can receive anything except it is given by God. And whatever is given by God is what can be kept by man. What God has not given, man cannot keep. Stand up on your feet.